Hello there, and welcome to the next tutorial video. Today we are looking at the next part, part 4 of the Unit 9 Harmony course. And today we are going to be looking at a different 6-4 grouping called the passing 6-4. This can be found in Unit 9. And what I'm going to be doing is using a couple of different examples on page 110. Something that's interesting about this is that the 6-4 in this combination with the passing 6-4 is basically like a harmonized passing note. If we think about this piece that we're looking at here, the A minor chord in this example in 9.7 could be thought of, if there was not a chord change here, as a passing note occurring between two chord tones. But because we have a different chord that occurs in the middle, we do have a combination of notes where it sounds like there's a passing note that occurs in the bass, but the interesting thing is the passing note is harmonized. With a chord that occurs in a strong manner, in the sense that this, in this case, the dominant 6-4, but then we go right to another inversion of the one chord right afterwards. So even though there's a chord change here, it will be called this another progression, in which the 6-4 is used as a passing function. There are a variety of different passing 6-4 chords that we can use, but usually the 6-4 can be used on the dominant note or the tonic note. In this case, you can hear the bass moving up. But the arpeggios are occurring in the right hand. There's an interesting chord change. But essentially, the 6-4, even though it is a chord change that occurs, 1-5-1, the 6-4 in itself as a second inversion chord is not technically strong enough to stand alone. It has to be used in a sequence. And so this passing 6-4 sequence is a very effective way to evoke a mood, to enhance the descriptive quality of a piece of music, but it does not have the harmonic strength to be its own chord, if you will. So there are four different combinations that work best. There is the, let's see here. There is the 1-6-V-6-4-1-6, the 1-6-V-6-4-1, 4-1-6-4-4-6, and 4-6-1-6-4-4. Boy, that's a bit of a tongue twister. But you can see how we have the one chord going to a second inversion chord, and then its inversion right after that. There's 1-1-6, or vice versa. Then you can also do the same, 4-1-6-4-4-6. In each of these cases, that there's a passing combination of notes that occur in the bass, and the harmonized chord is also occurring with common tones and with notes that are very close together. So it really creates a nice smooth sound, and basically a harmonized passing note is the result. I do hope this information was helpful, and take care and have fun as you continue to work on your music. Bye for now.